My twisting technique is not technically right, but hey, it works for me, so maybe it'll do the same for you. But the first thing that I do is, as I come out of my whatever skill that gives me the most power, I lift my arms up in a circle. Not a connected circle, but just an open circle. And after that, as I'm lifting up, I turn to the side slightly, and I look in between my shoulders, not behind, so not like this, but here. See this? Here. And as I'm ready to twist, what I do is I pull everything in here. And the key thing to this part is when you're twisting, guys, you want to try to make sure that you don't drop your shoulder. I twist to the right, so I'm demonstrating on this side, but that you don't drop your shoulder. So don't go here. You want to just stay here. And a good drill you can do is just replacing your shoulders. So what you want to do is, I twist to the right, so I'm putting my left shoulder to my right and my right shoulder to my left. So here, and just keeping everything in an upward motion. So I go, arms up, boom. And when I wrap in, these three things are very, very important. What I do is, when I wrap, I look when I put my arms in, and I flex my stomach as hard as I can. And I hold that until I'm ready to open up. some things that I see in some people's twisting, what they do is, if they want to do a double, they will spin and they'll keep looking. And when they get to the 1.5, they will tend to stop looking. You don't want to stop looking, because if you stop looking with your head, your body will stop spinning. Whatever your head does, your shoulders follow. So if you got 2 spins to do, you got to hold that look until you feel yourself complete 2 full rotations. And where I look, I try to think about looking behind my shoulder so it stays there the entire time. And I try to keep my hands right here. And it all has to be a fast motion. I try to think of making it as fast as like a blink. So it's not like this, but it has to be really, really, really fast. So key things on twisting is, arms up in a circle. Look in between your arms. In between your arms when you're turning. Not over your shoulder. When you're wrapping, make sure you're replacing your shoulders. So here, instead of like this. And looking and flexing when you wrap, all at the same time. So here, instead of arms, head, and then flex all together. And then hold your spin. To hold your spin, you want to keep looking the entire time. If you stop looking, then you will stop. Another question I always get asked is, do I get scared? Yes. I probably get scared, probably more than you do, actually. You wouldn't believe it, but yeah. You can ask anybody who's ever recorded me, I get scared quite a bit. And I'll tell you straight up, I don't even care. Because I believe you need to not be in denial and be like, hey, I ain't scared. No. You need to confront your fear and just get over it. So some things that help me get over it is, if I have a round off back hamstring double back to do, I don't think about falling on my head throughout the entire skill. Because if you focus on falling on your head in your round off, in your back handspring, in your rebound, and in your pulling of the double back, then yes, you're going to fall on your head because you're not in the moment and focusing on perfecting those little bitty things when you have to do the skill. So what you want to do is you want to try to make sure that you always focus on what you have to do when you're doing it. Don't just think about, oh, I'm going to fall throughout the whole skill, because yes, you will fall. Whatever you think, that becomes your reality. But yeah, that's what really helps me. But other than that, I mean, yeah, that's what really helps me. That helps me a lot, quite a bit actually. So try that and post some videos. Let me know how it goes. If you have any questions, just let me know. How do I fall safely? Well, I wouldn't say that it's safe falling, but what really helped me mainly was that I taught myself how to tumble. So like crash and burn was the way for me to learn. But also in my tumbling years, these things I have noticed have also helped me to not get hurt as I fall. Let me knock on some wood. But as I'm falling, I don't really panic. I just accept the fact that, okay, you're about to fall, you might die, but hey, it's okay. You just gotta really accept it and try not to resist against it. Just let it happen. You don't wanna try to tense up and try to prevent yourself from falling, because then that's when bad things happen. What you also wanna do is just go limp. Just let your body flow. Just let your body flow into the motion of your crash. Yeah. Try not to panic and just go limp, really. And just, as Bruce Lee say, be water, my friend. But just let it happen, you know. Try not to resist against the motion of your crash. But those are just some topics that I get asked about. So I kind of thought that I would go over them, and hopefully they can help you. If they don't help you, I'm sorry. I tried. And if they do help you, then good. Whoop-de-doo. So post some comments on this video. Let me know what you think. All that good stuff. But I want to say thanks from me and Julian for y'all supporting this series. Y'all are a big motivation for us, so we want to try to give y'all something back. But hope y'all have a good day.